Hello, everyone. I'd like to start my presentation with acknowledgement of country. I'd like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land of where this presentation is taking place, the Dja Dja Wurrung people, and I pay my respects to their elders past, present and emerging. I'd also like to recognise the Victorian Rabbit Action Network, or VRAN, its board, the mentors and the community participants that contribute to our VRAN programs. I'd also like to acknowledge the friends of VRAN, Andrew Woolnow, Professor Ted Alter, Lisa Adams and my colleagues at Agriculture Victoria, Lauren Hull and Michael Reed. My talk today is about a community initiative that we've implemented to improve how we manage rabbits in Victoria. It recognises that rabbit management is not only requires a science solution, but a people solution. We have a really good set of tools for controlling rabbits, but it takes communities and organisations to work together to make them effective. The Victorian Rabbit Action Network mentor program came about on this basis, and it's been funded by the Victorian Government under the Australian Government's Agricultural Competitiveness White Paper. And the work has been led by the Victorian Rabbit Action Network Board, mentors with support from Agriculture Victoria. Today, I'll start my presentation with some background about rabbit management in Victoria, and then I'll outline the project's approach and the activities we've used to build capacity to strengthen the rabbit system. And then I'll finish off with some outcomes from this work and where we're heading next, and closing with an invitation for you all. Rabbits are not a complex problem. They are wicked. People are using various methods to control them, and there is just as many opinions on how we manage rabbits as there are groups involved in controlling them. In Victoria, this includes community, farmers, traditional owners, land care, state government, local government, Agriculture Victoria, pest controllers, catchment management authorities, roads, railway, water authorities, science, and the list goes on and on. Typically, government have led programs through a mix of legislation, compliance, and extension. And this has been complemented by a mosaic of community action, but not everyone works in collaboration on rabbit programs. So why a training program? What was our driver for change? In 2014, Lisa Adams undertook a series of interviews with stakeholders from all across the rabbit system. This exercise identified who were the key players involved in rabbit management and the rabbit system. It also showed us who was missing, and it illustrated where funding and information and resources flowed to and from. And what this work presented to us was what wasn't working. It showed us that many rabbit programs were planned and delivered not in collaboration. Programs were not using science or best practice, which led to wasting money. Communities with the problem didn't have the opportunity to have input into the decision-making or designing solutions. And expert and knowledge brokers were disappearing. It really showed us at how difficult rabbit management is. Out of these findings came the formation of the Victorian Rabbit Action Network, or VRAN. VRAN is a community pest management group, and it's led by a group of skill-based leaders from both community and government, and their role is to invest in and champion community-led action. The group brings together people with a stake in rabbit control, and they come together to design solutions that are built on local knowledge and expertise. It's democratic practice at its best. So to improve the rabbit system, VRAN's main focus has been to direct funding to the implementation of a training course to boost rabbit control expertise in Victoria to ensure that all our programs are delivered that are effective and sustainable. VRAN have brought together a group of mentors with expertise in rabbit control to share their knowledge and experience with participants in best practice rabbit control. And one of the key elements of our mentor program is that they come from a diverse range of backgrounds, that is land care, local and state government, research and industry, and land management. The training isn't being delivered by just one type of expert, and this diversity and knowledge adds real value to our program. The mentors can share their success stories and motivate participants to continue the long haul of pest management. Our mentors run a 2.5-day training course, which we call fondly a boot camp, and they cover everything from best practice rabbit control to community engagement and lengthy legislation processes. To date, VRAN has hosted 4 of these training programs and involved over 70 trainees. And these people come from across community, industry, and government. And the course is held across different geographic locations, making the training accessible for anyone who wants to be involved. In our evaluation in 2020, it recorded that our program demonstrated good evidence that the training program has had increased engagement and awareness, knowledge and skills amongst the trainees. In many cases, our trainees were able to use and share their knowledge once they returned to their community or workplace. They had rabbit management programs well underway when they returned back and were adopting our teachings. This truly demonstrates practice change. The trainees also indicated that the design of the boot camp and the activities made the learning process engaging and the experience really enjoyable, leaving a positive and long-lasting impact on the participants. The crucial part of our course is that it's based on a ripple effect concept. That is that those 70 trainees take this new knowledge back to their communities and organisations, and they spread this information to a much wider network. They're truly breeding like rabbits. And to maintain this ripple effect, the trainees are invited to become part of an ongoing learning network or a community of practice. We host a couple of learning network meetings throughout the year all across Victoria. These sessions are self-driven and they're focused on the challenges of the group members that they face, such as absentee landholders, working amongst threatened species or peri-urban environments. The trainee and mentor structure is still really there, but the activity is more focused on sharing an experience and strengthening relationships. I'd like to share with you a short video that captures the value of the mentor program from the perspectives of the mentors and the trainees.
Rabbits are across Victoria, and particularly in those rabbit-prone soil types. And VRAN is wherever the rabbits are, basically. And the community needs information and knowledge to be able to do best practice rabbit control. And that's why VRAN travels to find those places and work with those people across Victoria.
The demonstrations themselves provide the stimulus for conversation. And out of those conversations, as we've discussed, that doesn't need to be scripted because the people themselves provide us with all the information that we can use then to help build the learning process. But by and large, the learning process is based on what people see, feel and do and hear.
I think it's marvellous that you've got this training program today to teach the next generation how to manage rabbits, because we've become complacent and we need some more diligent help to get rid of them, because they will come again.
The role of mentors in this program is absolutely critical to the sustained future for it, and extending the knowledge and understanding of rabbit control across the state. Mentors, as individuals, come from geographical areas, but then when they return to their areas, they can take that knowledge with them. In my role as a mentor, I feel very privileged to be able to have that opportunity to share that with people and to allow them to extend that knowledge beyond my current location and across the state of Victoria.
There's a lot of experience, and it's having that opportunity to actually spend some time with the mentors and actually learn from that experience has been really good.
Yeah, they've been excellent. The mentors are extremely knowledgeable, really helpful, happy to answer any questions.
Mentors at this camp, first thing is that they communicate with people, because as soon as you start hearing the stories that people have got to tell, then you have an idea of how it is that your experience can support and extend their knowledge.
And no question is ever a silly question.
A special thanks to all those people that participated in the video. The democratic practice, collaboration, training programs and learning network has been one of VRAN's biggest successes. And in 2019, Agriculture Victoria and the Victorian Rabbit Action Network were recognised internationally when they received the United Nations Award for Public Service, delivering a more inclusive and equitable service to leave no one behind. This was truly a true honour and has inspired VRAN to work even harder to leave no one behind in their programs. But VRAN haven't stopped the training programs. They've also run a few grant programs to build local capacity and engage their communities on the Rabbit program. Our Learning Network grant program was to provide an opportunity for trainees that participated in our boot camps to go back to their community or workplace and share their knowledge and become that next go-to person. The Community Action Grant program was an opportunity for community groups that were actively working in the system or aspiring to be, to bring their communities together to talk about the rabbit issue. The outcomes of this small investment program is not only numerous events and people engaged, but there's also the unmeasurable biodiversity and agricultural benefits, as well as mental health benefits. To me, the most rewarding was to witness grant recipients go on to apply for our next boot camp. So what has this all meant for rabbit management in Victoria? Well, from our evaluation of the project, VRAN has truly had a significant impact on the rabbit system in Victoria. We've seen more effective knowledge sharing, particularly between departments and land managers. We've recorded that over 80% of our people involved in our programs go on to share their new knowledge with others and individuals. We've seen practice change. Almost all participants say they're making changes to their rabbit programs when they return to their workplace or community. Succession, we're seeing a wave of succession where trainees in the first program are recruiting others to participate in our courses. And we've also seen a growing emphasis on and a preference to community collaboration, recognising that it's better to work together and that everyone can contribute expertise. Community-led action, allowing groups to identify and solve the problem before compliance and enforcement is required. And lastly, changes in mindset and attitudes. Trainees report that they are more motivated and confident as a result of being a part of our VRAN program. They have the knowledge and skills, and now they can access mentor support whenever they need. So what's next for VRAN? Well, helping people help the land is a long-term mission of VRAN. The Victorian Rabbit Action Network's goal for 2021 will be to secure ongoing funding to continue to invest in these training programs. There is true value investing in these activities, and we want to continue growing a statewide network of community, industry, science, and government participants around community-led action. I'd like to finish up with an invitation and a challenge. We're interested in collaborating with partners to continue the program and to extend our reach. If you'd like to work with VRAN to implement a model that's similar, please get in touch. Or if you'd also like to know more about how democratic practice and collaboration works, contact us as well. I hope our insights have been useful. We challenge you to think differently about designing programs with communities at the table, to think differently about what expertise looks like, and to recognise that great things can be achieved through community-led action. Thank you.